AI generated shit. Finally home from school. The weekends begin once again. Which means, back to focusing my life on doing this goddamn hellhole. I'll be doing the whole Lost Word shit as well. I'm gonna get that fucking X-tier Koakuma. And no one can stop me. Apart from maybe my luck, because it appears I'm pretty much fated to get it via the exchange. Dear Lord, Ilu. Anyway, I got plenty of time. I do want to play some more Breath of the Wild. So who knows how much I'll be doing. Loading times. Terrible. Nani. Frick. They're rerunning Yakumo's ambition. That event was only a few months ago. Oh, more Aru Village. Quests. I'm done with this team. What do I want as a focus this time around? I can try Klee. I can just give her Yoimi as artifacts for now and see how that works out.
Todoko? Todoko, where are you?
Why not? I'm really curious. Why are Yoimiya's artifacts so damn good?
Klee can help!
Been a while, Klee. Ask for her support.
What are my orders?
Gun, you can help. Healer Shinobu, why not? I want someone who can inflict an element with just her, with just their skill. Some kind of sub DPS. Oh. She could work. Rose Swirl might also be useful.
Yeah. It is as the stars foretold.
Now ain't this a team? I meant to talk to. What are your, how are your tiny legs gonna compete? With my tall ass legs, if I had Yellen, this would not even be a contest. What are these? I don't have the necessary bait. Still much of the land to explore, but so far the story, once again, is really not letting us, not really taking us to them. The point of having an open world if your story isn't even gonna let you explore said open world and do stuff in it with it. They're much more interested in telling some weird ass fucking political intrigue.
next on the agenda?
Making us all tie up somehow to our brother suddenly getting captured or whatever.
Access denied.
Our bond is strong. Lightning purified.
Decided by destiny.
Following orders.
Jumpy Dumpty, go!
Take that!
La la la.
Skipping the cutscenes is so annoying.
Shadows of Fate! Born of Ice and Frost! Glaze over!
Jumpy, jumpy, go!
Into death.
That really hurt.
Touring light show. Gosh darn it. Why is Genshin still so laggy? Hello there.
Access denied. Fate is upon you.
Fine, fine, fine.
God damn it.
Born of ice and frost.
Have the time. Never mind. I need Dendro for that.
We're way behind schedule. Next on the agenda. Astra, thank you for completing Add Astra.
Right, I'll be right back. I wanna grab something to drink.
This new shipment of items, they're all so ridiculously overdesigned. I need to sell these now.
Why isn't it working? I don't get it.
The sight of shiny jewels always brightens my day.
Just take my word for it.
This new shipment of items, they're all so ridiculously overdesigned.
These parts are safe for sure. Why isn't it working? I don't get it.
Ridiculously overdesigned.
These parts are safe for sure.
If you lie on the grass, you can feel the heartbeat of the world.
Alright. Let's do this. let's get the story out of the way. Really?
Lisa said that the Knights of Avonius would help us get ingredients for Razor's wine, right? They should probably be ready by now. Let's go check.
Yeah, so please unbearable. I'm just gonna go back to using your Mia. Alright, where the hell is Cleese? There he is.
If you lie on the grass, you can feel the heartbeat of the world.
We want
more companions! Hooray!
Hey, it's been a while since I last saw him. Taylee. You don't provide shields, don't you? I guess this will allow Doimiya to perform at her fullest.
Oh, how exciting!
What does your burst do again? Right, she's all about letting you constantly switch characters. And she's really weird. If I power up Beidou a little bit more. She could be a little fun to have around with Yoimiya.
It's time to pull the trigger.
It's two bow users, but what can I do?
Paimon wonders how Razor's class has been going.
Sucrose, wait! Honorary Knight, Paimon, please stop her!
Whoa, you scared Paimon!
Hello.
What's gotten the two of you so worked up?
Sucrose and I agreed to present the wine ingredient to you together. But when she heard that Razor will be showing up, she insisted that she won't spend a moment longer here than she has to.
I'm not good at dealing with strangers. Anyway, as long as the ingredient gets into the right hands, that's all that matters.
Oh, that won't do. We worked on this together, and we should present it together. I can't take credit for what you did.
It's not about the credit.
Wait, so does this mean the Knights of Avonius' ingredient is a product of bioalchemy?
Yes, it's a quadruple sweetness sunsetia.
Okay.
Quadruple sweetness? But aren't regular ones sweet enough as it is? Also, why a sunsetia?
Okay, let me give you the full story. I love the scent of wine, and after reading up on the art of winemaking, I've grasped some of the key principles. In short, whatever ingredients you use, it's essential to include something sweet. In an attempt to select the most suitable ingredient, I gathered samples of all the sweet plants and fruits I could find in the Mondstadt area. Then, I tried them all in turn and took detailed notes. I also factored in the differences between the same ingredient grown in different locations. For instance, sweet flowers from Springvale are a little sweeter than those at Cape Oath.
Wow, that sounds like a lot of work.
Noelle's a drunk.
It was no problem at all. Just my duty as a maid of Favonius. The chance to source the Defender's Will on behalf of the Knights of Favonius is a huge honor for me.
Noelle, your eyes are sparkling. But Paimon thinks it could be because of Lisa's brainwashing.
Anyway, I was worried that my evaluation would be too subjective if only I were involved. Thankfully, I ran into Sucrose the other day on her way out of the lab.
Oh no!
What is it, Sucrose?
Is it just me, or do I feel like
I left the lab that day?
Does Noelle have a different voice actor?
I was supposed to go and fetch some lab equipment we imported recently.
Oh.
Uh-oh. That look on your face seems to say you forgot all about it and have been in the lab this whole time.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh. Apart from her hangout event, she really hasn't ever shown up in another story since.
I'll go and see Marjorie about the equipment shortly. Carry on, Noelle.
Oh, I guess. I mean, it does have two whole acts.
Anyway, Sucrose is a true professional when it comes to this kind of research. I showed her my list, and she made some extremely valuable suggestions.
Please, you don't need to go out of your way to compliment me. Noelle filled me in on the background of the whole situation. I was moved to see how seriously she took this task, even though she'd never even met Razor before. However, none of the potential ingredients she had identified were perfect candidates. In my opinion, what we needed was a fruit high in sugar and easily fermentable. After a final look at Noelle's list, I picked the Sunsetia sample from near Cider Lake as a basis, with a view to improving it. Using bioalchemical techniques, we were able to amplify the sweetness, then conduct a few tests to compare the results against the benchmarks.
Oh,
watching Sucrose work on an experiment when she's in the zone blew me away. Such focus and determination.
I already said don't compliment people. Anyway, the result of our research is the Epsilon Series Tetrasweet Sunsetia, Variation 63. And it's finally ready. The sweetness has been verified through rigorous testing. And the size and color are both optimal, too. Noelle shortened the name to Quadruple Sweetness Sunsetia. Unfortunately, it can't be produced on a very large scale under the current conditions. But as long as we have enough for Razor. Traveler, there's something else I'd like to share with you. Growing up, I was lucky. I was never the best at dealing with other people, but my parents never placed any expectations on me. They never said to me, "You need to be more sociable," or anything like that.
Who are your parents,
anyway?
They
just said I should do what I enjoy. So, I'm well aware that I'm one of the lucky ones. I haven't lived Razor's life, and I can't pretend to imagine what it must have been like. So, I don't know how much it will mean coming from me, but I truly hope he can find happiness and spend his life doing what he loves.
Oh, Sucrose.
Cool.
Sorry, I am late again. Teacher forgot about the time. Kept talking and talking.
That's all right. We were just chatting. Whoa, deja vu. Paimon said the exact same thing 2 days ago. Wait a sec. Where did Sucrose go?
Wow, she disappeared the moment he opened the door. Hello, I'm Noelle, maid of the Knights of Favonius.
Hi.
Here's our ingredient for you. Oh, but I can't take full credit for it. I had help from an alchemist, but right now, she,
left.
Right, yes. It's a shame she couldn't be here to present it to you in person.
Smells like potion, nectar, and animal crystal fly, right?
Wow! Nothing gets past your nose, does it?
Crystal fly!
This sunsetia is sweeter than ones I have smelled before. Klee said alchemy is amazing. It can make things better.
That's right. I hope that this sweet fruit will help you brew the sweetest wine.
Live life and live love.
Thank
you
all.
She said that as well.
When she has time, I want to thank her also.
Leave that to me. I'll figure out a way to persuade her to not work so hard all the time so that I can introduce you to each other.
Okay, I will wait.
All right, now that we have all the ingredients, we can finally start making the wine. For that, we'll need a barrel, which, if Paimon remembers correctly, is waiting for us at the Angel's Share stand. Bye, Noelle! We're gonna head off now.
Good luck with everything. See you next time.
Well, that's big boobs.
Overall, I think this task was a success. Oh no! Sucrose's lab equipment! I should go help her carry it.
Hey, Leona. You're back.
Honorary Knight Razor over here! Look who it is!
Wow! It's Diona! Paimon was sure we'd run into you at the Cat's Tail stand sometime, but so far, we haven't seen you all festival!
Ooh, traitors.
What?
I get it.
I'm so mad!
Clee told me the whole story. So, this bright idea was the brainchild of you two? How could you? Razor is Daddy's friend. And he was a good influence. Right up until you got him interested in wine.
He also sounds like a different voice actor.
Razor, you better promise me that you won't turn into one of those old booze hounds that drinks themselves silly, slumps over the bar, and bursts into tears.
I don't understand.
Sounds like there's been some crossed wires here. Clee, what exactly did you say to Diona?
I told her that Razor's looking for his mommy with the Honorary Knight's help, and you both seemed really sad and said you needed some wine so maybe Diona could help. But before I finished, Diona said, Clee, say no more! I'm getting involved in this if it's the last thing I do! And then we came here.
Huh?
Okay. Paimon doesn't even know where to start. Diona, it sounds like Clee left out a few important details in the story. Let us set the record straight. So you're saying Razor wants to make the same wine that his mother and father once made? So he can learn more about them? You better not be making this up to try to pull the wool over my eyes.
It's way too specific to be a lie, don't you think?
Sorry, Diona. It was all Clee's fault for not explaining it properly. So, are you still mad? Or can you help Razor make the wine? I caught a bunch of fish for us to eat. And you can pet Dodoko too if you want.
I wasn't that angry. You were just trying to help. I understand. I just don't want Razor being led astray, that's all. That's why I may have raised my voice a little bit just now. Well, since none of you plan on drinking it, then I suppose I can help you just this once despite my reservations. But I need you to know that I'm a mixer, not a brewer. So I'm used to working with the finished product. If you really want me to start with a bunch of raw ingredients, that's fine. But I can't make any promises about how it'll turn out.
Gen should stop responding.
Yay! Diona is the best!
Okay. I have no
Bunch
doubt.
Of flatterers. Now watch this.
Oh, it crashed again.
We wait for a windier day. Does that mean we need to put it somewhere exposed to the wind?
Maybe Windrise? Very windy.
Yep, if you say the word windy, that's the first place on every Mondstadter's mind.
Cool, I want to come too.
I have to keep an eye on my foolish father, so I won't be joining you. Klee, come and play again some other time.
I will, I promise.
You can't use the artifacts to enhance weapons. Of course you're here.
Ah! What a curious coincidence meeting you here.
Don't get bored. What are you doing here?
Well, I awoke to the most magnificent aroma in the air. After following the sweet scent of fresh fruit to its source, this is where I ended up.
Yeah! The fruit are super fresh and super duper sweet. I can smell it as well.
Yes! I remembered something important. Something that you have to do before sealing the barrel and burying it in the ground.
What?
What? We missed something?
Razor, do you still remember the scent of that half bottle of Thousand Wind wine? I believe there was a hint of bitterness in there.
Yes, there was.
And with very good reason, too. The source? This!
Dandelion seeds?
You're familiar with dandelion wine, right? Well, the people of Mondstadt believe that the wind can bring back the soul, and also preserve memories. Dandelion seeds are like living gemstones, formed from the first wisps of wind in the year. People add them to the mix at the last second as a way of capturing the wind in the very moment that the barrel is sealed. The memory of that moment is then stored in the wine for all time. So, Thousand Wind Wine is the original dandelion wine.
Wow!
That's so cool! So now our story will be made into wine too!
As for why it always has a different scent, well, that's because people have the freedom to include whatever ingredients they want.
What is it, Razor? What you thinking about?
In Mother and Father's wine, I can smell dandelion seeds, but I don't know what else. In my wine, there is a lot of friendship. I still don't understand my mother and father, but I still have you and everyone else. Everyone has done so much for me. Farka, Teacher, Klee, Bennett, Uncle Brown Cat, Cold Lady, Grown Up with Fake Smile.
Grown Up with Fake Smile?
Gray Tough Girl, Person That Smells Like Animal Crystal Fly, Uncle Brown Cat's Daughter, Green Bard, Paimon, and Traveler. I remember everyone. Making wine is hard work.
Skills and stuff.
Making this wine needed everyone working together. Hard work with friends? Not so hard after all.
Indeed, no one respects wine properly.
I'm so happy.
Not even the fucking god of freedom and wine himself does.
Thank you. Friends are also Lupikal. Whether I'm human or I'm wolf,
sure.
It doesn't matter. From now on, all of us are together. When I grow up, we will come back here, and we will open this wine together.
And Koakuma's mine.
What a magnificent monologue. Even as a bard, I don't feel like there's anything else to add. All that remains now is to bury the barrel and wait for the fruit to ferment.
You certainly can, because you're an S-tier character.
Paimon feels like a celebration is in order! If Paimon remembers correctly, tomorrow should be wind coming day, right?
Wow! The animal god is coming home!
That reminds me. I haven't memorized the song for the toasting ceremony yet. I'd better get back. Friends, I shall see you all tomorrow. Get a good night's sleep tonight. Wait for the whisper of the gentle breeze to rouse you tomorrow morning. Then come and enjoy a performance by the greatest bard to ever grace the streets of Mondstadt.
Sure. You're a very drunk Jesus. Didn't mean to.
Razor, you were so cool back there.
Cool? But inside, I feel warm.
No, not like that. When you think something's awesome, you can say it's cool or sweet.
Oh, But I think Klee is sweet.
No. That's called flirting. They will have disease.
Leave it to me, all of it, whatever it is. What exactly is it?
Didn't quite catch your
wind coming day is finally here. Let's get a move on or we'll miss the toasting ceremony.
Bernard is busy completing the... No! I wanted to avoid you!
Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
Guess we're doing this. I expected more wind instruments. Mondstadt OST. Should be obvious why I think that.
We got all the funds you need!
Already? Wow, you sure work fast. All right, our suppliers are ready and waiting. Just give me a moment. What do you think? Not bad, huh? Of course, if you're in a creative mood at any point, feel free to redecorate the place however you want.
It's great! Really looks the part! The shop definitely needs a name, though. How about, Favonian Goodies? Paimon will take that as a compliment. Okay, Bernhard, so what do you need us to do next?
Gathering the funds was a monumental task. It must have been very demanding. So don't worry about all those other menial things that need doing. I'll handle those. You both have more experience than me. It'd be great if you could figure out the more managerial level things, like our sales strategy, SOPs, USPs, QC principles, KPIs.
Quality control principle.
I've got to be honest. I hear other store owners using these terms, but I can't say I really know what they mean. I just know they're important, which means they're probably best dealt with by you.
Oh, trust me, we're just as inexperienced.
We'll be the shop owners who make the big business decisions, and you'll be the shop assistant doing all the actual day-to-day work?
Yep. My strength is in execution. Your shop, your rules. I am but a tool to be used however you see fit.
Cool.
That sounds a little extreme. This is for charity, remember? We're not some cutthroat business executives. All right, why don't you go ahead and take a type 5, Bernhard?
Yeah.
The two of us need to touch base.
This is still capitalism. Liwei invented it, apparently.
Okay, we have a clear corporate mission statement. Our goal is to become the best darn snack shop in the whole festival market. Now let's all prepare to give 110% as we receive our first customers.
Only 110?
Traveler? Paimon? What a surprise!
Morning, official! You came to check out the market, huh?
Buy our shit.
One was wise to follow one's intuition and ask Lady Magistus to join the Princessin on a tour of this folk festival.
You wanted to get drunk? Are you on the age of consent?
Extraordinary events may yet unfold, even on this unexceptional autumn day. Splendid, most splendid.
Main Fräulein is battling hard to suppress the euphoria in her voice. Seeing you here has put her in the most wonderful mood.
Another crash. God, I love this game.
Oz, spare us your gratuitous embellishments.
Maybe you should leave me to do the explaining. Not long ago, Her Highness had a very nice dream and took it as a sign that something good was about to happen. Naturally, Her Highness's first thought was to come to me for some astrological guidance on the matter. She also noticed that the Vinlacefest was in full flow and asked if I was interested in checking it out with her. I, of course, agreed. I can take advantage of the festival period discounts to purchase some bulk supplies for my present column writing spree.
Okay.
I must admit, without Her Highness's reminder, the Vinlacefest may well have completely passed me by.
Lady Magistus, might Her Highness remind you that the dream of which you speak occurred no less than 9 days ago? And that only after awaiting Lady Magistus's return letter. In vain for all this time did one have no recourse but to rap most furiously upon the door to thy abode.
It's been 9 days already? 9 days! Where did the time go?
In light of the great importance this manuscript has to you, Lady Magistus, one shall not hold thy inattentiveness to the passage of time against thee.
But I would implore you, Lady Magistus, to be attentive at least to the nigh overflowing mailbox outside your door. There appear to be many others whose letters go unanswered.
I might know who they're from.
You are so immersed in your research that you forgot all about the time, stopped checking your mail, and almost missed out on a huge festival!
Did you sleep?
Anyway, time is of the essence. I have a lot of bulk buying to do.
Oh, you're in luck.
Speaking of which, it's quite a surprise to see you running your own shop. And a snack shop at that.
Indeed. We don't have a discount. Rather, our prices are just cheap to begin with.
Feel free to browse around.
So cheap, in fact. If we were to do a discount, why, it would be nothing more than daylight robbery. So, with that in mind, buy our shit.
Let me think. Can you recommend anything that, goes well with a drink?
Sure can! If you got the hangries, then look no further! Just that time and check the menu! Wait a sec. Goes well with a drink?
What drink?
Is the writing going that badly? You know drinking isn't gonna solve your problems, right?
As it happens, Main Fräulein has been visiting Mona quite frequently as of late. It is possible that Lady Magistus is feeling the pressure from the constant interruptions.
Special.
No, it's nothing like that. This has nothing to do with drinking or with Fischl's visits. You all need to calm down. Recently, Her Highness invited me to try her signature cold cut platter. Die Heilige Sinfonie. It had such a unique taste, and every bite was so sumptuous. Before I realized it, I had finished the entire plate.
Wow. Well, an empty plate is the highest compliment you can give to the chef.
Die Heilige Sinfonie is an excellent dish. It's filling, full of energy, and has a long shelf life. And, if I'm not mistaken, it's often paired with alcohol, yes? It is, in almost every respect, a far superior dish to the so-called satisfying salad. The sole exception being the steep price. Fortunately, however, the Weinlese Fest is upon us, a festival during which not only are wines sold at discounted prices, but also wine-related food products. This opportunity is a godsend. I cannot let it slip by.
Rejoice, Lady Magistus. That dish was but a spontaneous creation, hastily made in a moment of need while on a royal excursion. You
Would
shall
you like
have
a
many
fine
opportunities to enjoy
times.
Far finer culinary delights than this.
Main Fräulein means to say that this dish represents a mere fraction of her full capabilities.
But of course, far be it for me to suggest that the true breadth of Her Highness's culinary brilliance can be displayed in a single dish. However, I cannot
this
expect
is only
the
1%
sovereign
of
to
my
serve
power.
Her subject. What I mean is, I can't keep letting you cook for me when you're a guest in my home. At the very least, I should have something more than salad in store for when people come around. With any luck, I'll be able to find something to your taste here.
Huh? Mona, is that really what this is all about?
Oh, her intonation
Main
changed.
Fräulein, might I suggest alternative phrasing that would be more faithful to your style? Perhaps, long had I foreseen this, or thou needst not fret over thy affinity for salad.
Most indeed, Lady Magistus. You have long since earned the recognition of your princessin. Devote yourself to deciphering the secrets of the starry sky. You need not spend precious hours in search of additional ways to delight me.
Don't worry. I won't always be as busy as this. It'll be quite nice to work on some other skills when I have the time.
So are you buying or not?
Allow Favonian goodies to be the solution to your troubles. In addition to a range of ready-to-eat drinking snacks, we also have a wide variety of semi-prep dishes for sale. Why not get a few of each kind?
Lemon.
Finishing off these ready-to-cook meals at home is easy as pie, takes no time at all, and can help you improve your cooking skills. Then,
all proceeds go to charity.
You'll be ready to challenge yourself with some trickier dishes. We can even come and help if you want. The Traveler is really good at cooking. It'd be no problem.
Oh, sure. We don't have to help people.
That's a great idea. I'm almost tempted to increase my budget now.
This wasn't in the contract.
Lady Magistus, your princessin awaits your culinary masterpiece with great anticipation.
But please keep Paimon's suggestion in mind and allocate your time wisely.
Oh, you just wait. The next time you dine at my home, I'm sure you will be pleasantly surprised.
The Vonia and Goodies has just completed its first sale! That's right! And it makes Paimon so happy to see a delighted customer find something that they really like. Oh, Paimon never knew that selling things to people who need them could feel so fulfilling! Looks like being a shop owner is a pretty cool job after all! Alright, let's keep up the momentum and get our name out there!
Oh no. I'm finishing Razor's bullshit first.
Wow.
Oh, there it is.
So many people have shown up to welcome the Animal Archon! Why is everyone crowded around the Angel Share stand?
Tradition holds that the finest wine of the Vinlesa Fest only goes on sale after the Animal Archon has tasted it at the toasting ceremony. Everyone's waiting in line for the big moment.
Ugh. So welcoming the Animal Archon back is just a means to an end for them, huh? What about you, Lisa? Are you here for Razor?
Yes, I was feeling a little concerned about him, but I just spoke with him, and he tells me that the winemaking went very smoothly. Such a relief. A glass of the festival's finest will go down smoothly now, too.
Wow, you too, huh?
Razor and the others are over there. You should go say hi.
Hey, hey! There you are!
Whoa! What's with all these bottles? Selling your own homebrew now?
These are for Razor. From us!
Mommy said everyone's welcoming the animal god
today. It's originally an alcohol making term.
If the animal god likes the wine, he'll turn into the wind.
I'm so used to using the term for tabletops.
We want the animal god to be happy, so he helps Razor. Oh, honorary knight, look what Albedo let me borrow.
What?
This bottle is from my dad. Luckily, I managed not to break it on the way here. It's just for show, though. I have to give it back to them afterwards.
Mommy said that the animal god can drink a lot of wine.
He breaks it after.
She said if he wanted to, he could drink the whole of Cider Lake in one big gulp. So, do you think we'd have enough between these and the wine raiser's parents left behind?
Ah, Green Bard.
Green Bard.
Everyone, I am greatly honored to be able to be here today.
I have been invited by Acting Grandmaster Jean of the Knights of Favonius to perform a piece for everyone, Thousand Wind Wine. It is some of the finest verse I know. I dedicate it to the wind and to everyone here with us today. Fill up the barrels and store them away, then wait, wait for a windier day. Wax the bottles, seal them tight, for the south wind that soothes, for the north wind that bites. How does this fine wine taste to the tongue, as Mondstadt to the ear, like a sweet dream of freedom? And what are the fruits that went into the brew? An explorer's courage, a love tender and true. A defender's will, strong as yesteryear, joining the thousand winds in a song of good cheer, turning sour into sweet, bitter notes fade away as we wait, wait for a windier day.
Pray I'm tell guessing some budget went into teaching Venti's voice actors to sing.
Greatest triumph, the true liquid gold, as it flows from the keg. What sound drifts by? Wind chimes in the boundless, immemorial sky. We raise up our glasses and voices in song as we wait, wait for the wind to sing along. Where do we turn once the thousand winds take flight? To the tales of the lyre, to the sweet dream of tonight.
Dear friends, let us now open the wines.
To the Animal Archon!
To the Animal Archon.
There's no wind.
Don't feel sad, Klee.
But why didn't he come? If the animal god didn't come home, is it because he doesn't like the wine we brought for him?
Of course not. You know, Klee, the wind isn't the only form that the Animal Archon can turn into. He can turn into anything. So today, he must have come back looking like something else.
Huh? Really? Maybe he turned into a Jumpy Dumpty.
Sure.
Sure! Jumpy Dumpty it is! Hope you're listening, Animal Archon!
Racer, did the Animal Archon bring you a blessing?
Yes. I talked a lot with you all, and I learned a lot. Now, I am not afraid. I think that is a blessing.
Don't forget to save me a glass of your wine once it's finished fermenting.
How about me too? Why not?
Yes. We share together, and we remember together.
Yay! But now I'm getting thirsty.
Alcohol can't quench you.
Let's go get something to drink, shall we?
I heard that the Angel Share is selling a new drink called Fruits of the Festival. Everyone's saying it's delicious.
I want some! I want some!
Okay, everyone, let's go.
Where did these dandelions come from?
Take this, crush it, and place it on the fracture. Listen, Missy. Promise me you'll live on. This is where you must stay. You are our only hope. Forgive me, Kaya.
Good, very good. That's my boy. I will always be proud of you.
The time we spent on it, the wine still isn't ready. May as well leave it for our son.
Razor. What do you think of that name?
Oh, an adventurer's name. Yes, I like it.
Razor! Razor! Come on!
Right, the event's all but over now. I'll do them all tomorrow, though. For now, I'm done. Yeah, these will all wait. I'll focus in the final half and dedicate it all to doing the charity work, I suppose.
Ingredients for wine brewing need to be chosen carefully.
I can't try out the theme at all.
At affordable prices.
Welcome to the Vine Laser Fest.
Come on, come on.